Now we move on to another performance, and before moving on, we'd like to give you an understanding. We'd like to give you a brief about what's going to happen, what's the performance like, and for that, I have a very special person. We have Mr. Rajan Menon, who will introduce, who's from Thirunottam. He'll introduce the performance of Koodiyattam, which is going to be done here. I would like to request Sri Rajan Menon onto the stage, please.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to have a performance called a very typical Kerala classical theatre, and which is called Koodiyattam. Now, I've just got a few minutes to talk about Koodiyattam. I wouldn't want to keep you away from the performance while the stage is getting set. I'll start with giving you a small story to explain what Koodiyattam is all about. Well, before the independence, the Raja of Travancore had invited a Koodiyattam artist called Parameshwar Chakyar to his palace. And when he was invited, there was an Englishman who was still there as part of the government. He, his wife, and a very ferocious dog was present there. So as this artist came towards the palace, the dog went close to him, and the artist got a little surprised and got a little afraid. And he said, "Please, the dog, please take him away." The Englishman knew that his dog is not capable of biting unless and until told, and it's just a barking dog. But he was very ferocious, enough to give a lot of fear to this artist. So the Englishman did nothing about it. So when he was helped, when he found that no one is helping him to take the dog away, he appeared to be picking up a stone and threw it at the dog. The dog thought he was being hit, and he ran away whining and screaming. Immediately the Englishman and his lady was very upset that the dog was hurt, and they went and they didn't want to directly tell the artist, because he was a guest of the king. They went and complained to the king that this Chakyar, the artist, has hurt his dog. So the Chakyar went to the king. The king was asking him, and he said, "I did not throw any stone. I just showed that I was throwing a stone." So in order to defend himself, but the Englishman and his wife didn't believe that. They said, "You're lying." So he said, "Let me, just to prove his innocence and just to prove that and defend himself," he appeared to be picking up a granite, a large granite, took it near the Englishman and thumped it on his head. The Englishman fainted. He became unconscious and he was screaming. The lady was very upset also, and again said, "What the hell is this happening? Why is this guy hurting everyone?" After about an hour, after taking care of him, the Englishman came to his senses and he felt his head and said, "There's nothing wrong with his head and nothing had happened." So ladies and gentlemen, with this he was convinced that this person had not hurt him, but he just appeared to be enacting the art, this task of throwing a stone or hitting him on the head. This is what he called as Abhinaya. Abhinaya, to tell you very clearly, Abhinaya is a concept in Natya Shastra, the Indian science of acting. It's a concept in Natya Shastra, and it literally means leading the audience towards a sentiment. So this is Abhinaya, and what you're going to see today on Koodiyattam is complete Abhinaya. Koodiyattam, to tell you very clearly, it is a concept, it is the ultimate form of Natya Shastra, and an ultimate in Abhinaya can be seen in Koodiyattam. We were lucky today to have these artists, because we, the organization called Thirunottam, has been conducting its annual festival at the GEMS Wellington School. Today is the fourth day of the festival. We've been having these programs for the last 6 years, and We normally have it running right from the morning 9 o'clock right through to 11 o'clock in the night, and it comprises of almost all the classical art forms of Kerala, like Kathakali, Koodiyattam, the percussion ensemble Thayambaga. So this is what we've been doing. Thirunottam is an organization, not-for-profit organization, which has been intensely involved in promoting this classical art forms of Kerala in Dubai. And we have been successful. We've been running it quite well. If you look at the support that we have been getting from corporates and media partners, and the fact that we have been able to have very close to 5,000 to 6,000 people floating population in the auditorium over the last 3 to 4 days. So I will not take too much of your time, but what you're going to see today is a small part of Koodiyattam. Koodiyattam normally can go, it's a theater which normally can run up to 4 hours and 5 hours. In the early days, it used to be it used to be very secluded place. It used to order. Today, it's moving out. It has moved out into Paris. You find Koodiyattam recitals going on in Paris, in London, and so many other places. The story today, which will be enacted in a very short while, it's a very minuscule attempt to show you what Abhinaya is all about. This is taken from one of the epics of India called Mahabharata. It's a scene in the forest when the Pandavas were staying in the forest, and the wife of Bhimsena, she expressed her desire to possess a few Saugandhika flowers. Eager to satisfy her desire, Bhima sets out to the mountains where only these flowers are found. The play begins with this going out of Bhima in search of these flowers. Bhima has to go to a thick forest on his way to these mountains. He describes the terrifying nature and atmosphere of that forest. Very quickly, as they are still getting ready, a very huge python coming out of its cave approaches an elephant and digs its teeth into its leg and drags him. While the elephant is roaring with pain, a lion pounces upon its head and dashes it to the bones and draws out the broken pieces of bone. Then when the elephant shakes his head, the lion pierces the neck of the elephant with its claws. This is what Bhimsena is seeing in the forest. He's seeing a tussle between a python, a lion, and an elephant. Gesticulation, look, a lion digs its teeth and claws into the body of an elephant and drags him. How is this possible? The elephant was asleep. The elephant has also been already attacked by a python, which has caught hold of the leg of the elephant. The elephant suddenly awakens from its sleep and tries to escape. The python continues to drag the elephant's leg. The elephant roars loudly with pain and fear. Hearing the elephant's roar, a lion suddenly runs in that direction. It pounces upon the head of the elephant, strikes his head, drinks his blood, and tears his body with its teeth and claws. This is what we are going to enact here. And I wouldn't take too much of your time as the artists are coming in. We thank very much Radio Me for having given us this opportunity, not only to tell you what Thirunottam has been doing, but also to show you a very small clip of Abhinaya, the art of leading the audience to a certain sentiment. Thank you very much.